Oh, got him. Oh, the good one. A really, really good one. Oh yeah. Oh yes, dude. Nice, nice largemouth. Yeah. Oh, look at that one. That is awesome. What a chunk. Oh, look at him. Sweet. Yes. Mitch and I have been, you know, it's a trial and error whenever you're hitting new bodies of water, but there's a lot of rock and just an incredible amount of mixed habitat. Look at those trebles, those braided trebles. Once they hit those things, they are screwed. I had that bait in walking mode. That's the prop walker. I'm gonna let this guy go. You know, ever since I was a kid, I started dabbling in topwaters and kind of started throwing popping baits. And after that, learned about walking baits and learned pretty quickly that a walking bait is such a good tool for catching big bass. You know, that's just a walking type bait right there. It's actually a prop walker. This thing has a little sneaky secret up its sleeve. Most of the time I'll probably keep it in the walking mode, but it has little fins that you can deploy that shoot out the side of the bait and then they rotate. So then you can just straight wind it. I'll show you right here. You can straight wind it almost kind of like a plopper bait or kind of like a buzz bait. But the beauty of that is that you have treble hooks. See how that thing spins? So I can just take that, like if I'm going over a weed flat or something and I just want to cover a lot of water, I can just straight wind it. And has a real nice subtle bloop, 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 bloop. And those wings, when you go to cast it, they fold, you know, they fold back like that, so that it'll go through the air very aerodynamic like, and then they hit the water and they deploy and then they start rotating. So it's a really pretty cool bait to just cover water with. Like if I know I'm in an area where there's a lot of fish, I'll just walk that bait. But if I'm just kind of hunting and looking and get a feel for what's going on, I can just cast and wind this bait and I can cover a lot more water that much more quickly. Because if I know I'm in an area where there's a lot of fish, I want that enticing sachet walk the dog presentation, because that, in my mind, gets a lot of bites, and it, for me, it gets big bites. That's what I love so much about a walking bait. If anybody fishes topwaters, you know that the hookup ratio can be kind of hit or miss depending on the day and, you know, how well the fish are feeding. But I did a little upgrade to these hooks. These are a braided treble hook. So if a fish just comes up and even swipes at it, these hooks have such a great tendency. The swinging action of them, they're just like gaffs. They are just screwed when a fish comes up and even looks at the thing. So that's really nice when you're walking the dog and when you have it in the prop mode. So with these hooks being super sticky, tack sharp, the free motion, you can notice the free motion in the hooks. That's what really, really allows a fish to, you know, when a fish comes up and they have that suction and they suck in, these hooks really have a tendency to, you know, the fish can breathe when they come in and vacuum that bait. The first thing that starts going in toward their mouth are going to be those hooks, because that vacuum pressure, when they suck in, those hooks are so free swinging that they end up going right into their mouth. When I am looking for fish, you know, depending if I have this lure in the walking mode or the prop mode, I want something that's really universal as far as being able to either come up into these bull rushes and make a real pinpoint accurate cast and walk the bait out of there, and or put the bait into prop mode and make a really, really long cast out over a big open weed flat that's, you know, there, in this particular lake, we've found that there's just tons and tons of cabbage for miles. And with that open water, you know, there's a lot of cabbage underneath, but the surface is very clean and clear. You know, this is a long rod. It's got a little bit of a parabolic action to it. And I'm using 30 pound braid, and I've got a fluorocarbon leader, 15 pound. And I really like the fluorocarbon leader. It kind of helps keep the nose of that bait down. And I'll fish that with pretty much any topwater. Is that big shank of heavy fluoro. I just feel like it kind of glues the bait to the surface, especially if I'm covering water with a walking bait and I'm trying to cover water quickly. It keeps the nose of that bait kind of glued into the water, and I feel like the bait just performs better. So I have a long rod. I can make a really, really long cast out into outer space over, you know, if you have schooling fish or something, and fish that are swiping at a bait, that's where those hooks really come into play. And with that long rod and the straight, you know, the straight braid, I'm usually not a guy that uses much for drag when I'm kind of in close quarter combat fishing, flipping a jig or something like that. But if, with a topwater out in open water, treble hooks, I have some drag, so when I lean into a fish, and if it's a big one, I don't tear hooks out. Little bit of drag, parabolic rod, you're good to go. Long casts, you're golden. You catch a lot of big fish.